So in a world when everyone is abuzz about smartphones and tablets, I'm here to tell you about how we're building desktop computers. Why desktop computers, everyone always asks. And the answer is because you cannot enter the knowledge economy without being able to write a CV, to do a school research report, to do a budget. To enter the modern economy, you must have computing literacy. 4.5 billion people do not have access to that. 4.5 billion people. What's so incredible is that it's actually not that hard to solve it. What does that mean? How do 4.5 billion people not have it, and it's not that hard to solve it? The answer comes in the form of technology that people already have. Everyone already has a television. That's a monitor. And attached to those televisions are set-top boxes, cable boxes, satellite TV boxes. And that little box is where the magic takes place. If you take an iBook from the year 2000, your average set-top box today has 4 times the storage and 60 times the RAM as an iBook in the year 2000. It is a computer. So why is it that all of these computers, monitors, and set-top boxes as CPUs are not actually computers? And the answer is actually really simple. Software. We spent about a year trying to take existing solutions and put it on set-top boxes and make that happen. After a year, we threw it all away, gave up, and spent the subsequent 3 years building that from scratch ourselves. A desktop operating system that is simple enough that it doesn't require training, that doesn't get viruses, that runs on these cheap processors, making a computer cheaper than a tablet, and most importantly, that is built for users in emerging markets. Because people in emerging markets not only can't afford computers, they can't afford access to fundamentals like education, health, and livelihood. So a computer can be an answer to that. Now, I was supposed to get on stage and tell you stories about the seamstress that can now have access to shopping for microfinance loans, and the farmer who can figure out what to plant, when to irrigate, and where to sell. But in the audience tonight, I actually found a new hero of mine. He's a little 12-year-old boy who 8 months ago couldn't speak English and decided to teach himself English through his computer. And I'd like to have you meet him. Jimmy, please welcome me on stage.
There. Hello.
So tell me about yourself, Jimmy.
Hi, everybody. My name is Jimmy. I'm 12 years old, and I really like to play video games and read books.
So how did you learn English?
I learn English by practicing and reading, listening. I already end the program Duolingo. I'm practicing in videos, Skype, and writing on WhatsApp.
So he was having a fluent conversation. I speak Spanish. The conversation was easier had in English than it was in Spanish, because his conversational English is so good. And tell me, how much English did you know 8 months ago?
Oh, I learned 8 months ago, or March of the last year.
And how much did you know 8 months ago?
Nothing.
And you were saying something about programming?
Ah, yes, I'm learning programming in Khan Academy.
Programming? Tell me,
yes.
What sort of programming?
Just animation. I really like it. It's very hard, but I like it. I always practice it.
My new hero. There are 1 billion Jimmys about to get technology. It's incredible what we are about to see as humankind. And the reason I'm on this stage is to make a call to the entrepreneurs of the world. The this of that, the Uber of X, has been done before. Meanwhile, emerging markets have so many needs and so many opportunities. WhatsApp sold for $19 billion, the largest startup acquisition in history. Why? Because it gave the power of communication to 450 million emerging market users. M-Pesa is a mobile payments platform that currently runs 31% of Kenya's GDP through it. The opportunities of our era exist here in Guatemala and emerging market countries just like it. And this child right here is testament to what that means. Thank you all. Jimmy, you're a hero.
Thank you very much.